This crash happened more than a week ago, but the case is not over yet. Channel 4 Action News reporter Sheldon Ingram live in Etna tonight. And Sheldon, crews back out there today reconstructing this accident.
That's exactly right. This deadly crash still has the attention of Pennsylvania State Police as they conducted their accident reconstruction of Route 28 just behind me across the river. At the same time, the family is still open about its grief.
We're feeling a great loss. It's not the same.
Rikki Fleming's family is still buried under a cloud of grief and misery. This is Pennsylvania State Police going through their accident reconstruction today, more than a week after the 18-year-old was killed. How fast was Jared Schillinger moving when he rear-ended Fleming? This is the crash scene. Are there skid marks to prove he hit the brakes before impact? If not, why? Was he swerving and driving erratically long before the deadly crash? And what did his passengers witness? Those are the questions investigators hope to answer.
She had happened to be going in the same direction as this Jared, and she seen the way he was driving all over the road, zigzagging in and out of traffic.
Meanwhile, Fleming's family is still hurting. The 18-year-old died on the scene from horrific injuries. A relative tells Channel 4 Action News the impact from the rear-end collision was so fierce, Fleming was thrown through the hatch of her vehicle. She suffered head trauma. Her heart was punctured. And as police continue with the investigation, the family asks for only one thing.
Justice.
And state police are still awaiting the results of the toxicology tests of Schillinger. At the same time, they say it could be months before they receive the results of accident reconstruction. Reporting live, Sheldon Ingram, Channel 4 Action News.